we're trying to do, and we approach this in an algebraic fashion, is we want to get n by itself. If there's anything that is being done to n, any numbers being added or multiplied or raised to the power of, or whatever we want to, whatever there's happening to n, we want to kind of undo that and leave n by itself. So what's something we could do to this side that would leave it so it's just n?
+1.4.
Let's see. And -1.4 is +1.4 is?
Zero.
So we have n plus zero. Is that good?
Yeah.
That's good for us because n plus zero is the same as n. Why do we have to do this to the other side too?
Because
why
we have to do one
to
side.
Equal it out.
Because.
To balance it.
To keep it balanced. Balance when it's given to us, we don't want to mess that up. We want to keep it balanced. So -6.3 +1.4. Let's see, 1.9. So
-4.9?
Yeah. Okay.
I got -7.7.
You added.
I got the same thing.
Are you subtracted 1.4 from it?
No, all the rates are for 17.
I put the minus in 14.
Yeah, so you subtracted 1.4 is what you did.
None of mine. I give you 4.
Okay. -6.3. Where is -6.3?
Behind it.
To the left. -6.3. I want to add 1.4. What does it look like to add 1.4?
Go to the
right. It's not going to be big enough to come to zero or beyond. It's going to somewhere be in here. +1.4. Okay. So you should have at least an idea in your head that this number is going to be closer to zero than this. Okay. When I'm doing this in my head, I know that it's going to be a negative number, and I know it's going to be, it's really the difference between 6.3 and 1.4. But I know this answer is going to be negative. This is how I handle this in my head. You borrow 6, or borrow 10 from the 6, 10 tenths. And 5 becomes 13, this is 9. Right? And 5 minus 1 is 4, okay? But I know this, I'm going to report this as a negative number because we're actually coming from -6.3 and we're adding 1.4.
Can we do number 17?
We can. Number 17. With a pen. Please keep the talking to a zero level. Okay. I'm going to have to write out this thing here. Frame number 9, frame number 10, final score. Double-checked, and there's not any of that kind of weirdness here. It's pretty straightforward if you know what these symbols mean. So in bowling, every frame you have 10 pins to knock down. 2 tries to knock down those 10 pins, okay? So this person knocked out 8 in the first try, and in the second try, what happened?
Gutter ball,
and missed somehow, okay? And they have a score of 89 in the 9th frame. Next, after 89, what do they do their first try?
7.
Knock down 7, what happens?
Gutter.
This slash like that means?
Spare.
They knock down those 3, right? And then, well, in the 10th frame, if you knock down all 10 pins, you get to try again. Okay? You get 3 throws in the 10th frame. So for the first one, they knocked over 7, then they spared, and then they knocked over 6. Final score is 105. 89 plus 10 plus 6 more, 105. Okay? Then you, this is you, you knock, I'm explaining bowling right now. 6, you knock down 6, okay? And then you knock down 3, which was not all of them, it was just the total of 9. Right, so now your score is 82, which means that in the frame before your score was a 73. Right? You knock down 9 more pins, you have 82. You knock down 9 pins, what's your score now? It was 82, now you knocked down 9, how many is it now?
91.
Yes, 91. So right now it's 91, but you know, what happens next? That's what we're trying to figure out. Okay. So what did they tell us about your score? Your friend's final bowling score is 105. Your final bowling score is 14 pins less than your friend's final score. Couldn't we just say what that is then?
Yeah,
our final score?
105
minus 14. What's that?
91.
So our final score is 91. We know that, okay? No need to stress about that. Write and solve an equation to find your final score.
Oh.
You have 82. You know you wind up with 91. Actually, what do you have right now?
91.
You have a 91.
No, you have a
90.
No, you have a
90. You had 82, you bowled
9. You had
91. Not much of an equation. I could have made this a little harder.
No, this is really
easy. Well, we should be able to add this score to this score. We should be able to add what happens here and get, well, this would be our final score, really. Okay. So if we call that x, we could say 82 plus x, like what happens in that final frame equals 91. But how would we solve this equation?
Minus
82 on both sides. Now we have a 0, x plus 0. Minus 82. What's 91 minus 82?
11.
11.
No,
14.
9.
Yeah.
It's
9. 4. What? No. Oh, wait. So that means we need to bowl a 9 in the 10th frame to get to our final score, which we know is a 91. And we've thrown a 9, so what happens after we've thrown that 9? After we've knocked down the 9 pins?
Then you count them up.
How do we do after that? After we've shown those 9 pins, or knocked down those 9 pins, and we go again, what happens next? If our score is an 82 in the 9th frame, and our final score is a 91, to get from 82 to 91, you just need to knock down 9 pins.
So
far, you do terribly. You miss, and then, well, if you don't knock down all 10, you don't get another throw. Okay, you don't get that third throw, so that doesn't count. But nothing happens. You don't. You throw a gutter ball or you just miss the pin you were going for. It says your friend made a spare in the 10th frame. Did you make a spare in the 10th frame?
What's
a spare?
No.
A spare is, if I knock down 9, there's one left. And if I knock down that 1, that's called a spare.
No, you didn't get a spare.
Nope, we did not knock out. We got 9, that's it. That's all we need to get to our final score. We must not have gotten that spare. Aubrey?
Do you bowl?
Your phone's ringing.
I used to.
I like bowling. I have a question. Like, could you go back to the other page?
Yeah.
Like the answers on it?
Oh, the answers, yes.
Okay, so. Your phone's ringing? Yeah, number 18. Don't you have to put a 1 in front of the X?
I have to write it.
Where, here?
No, 18.
18. A 1 in front of the X?
Yeah. Or could you do, because yesterday you told us we had to put the 1 in front of the X, or could we just leave it the X?
Oh. If I made it sound like you have to put a 1, I apologize. You don't have to put a 1.
Okay.
Right?
You don't put a 0 either?
No.
I give a hand that I need.
I mean, that's what we're trying to get, and I may have written 1X quite a few times, but it's just to emphasize why we're doing what we're doing. Like, we're going to, you know, divide by 3. Why? Because that gives us a 1 times X, right?
Okay.
1 times X. Just like x plus 0 is x. So you don't need to write a 1 there, it's always understood. If there's not a number there, the number that is there, the 1. Okay, 15, 17. Other questions? ready to do this? Clear our desks?
Yeah, sure.
Not sound like this. Trying to be polite. Help little hints like saying things such as, let's start with number one. That's a signal. How do we get x by itself in this equation? Yes?
Minus x on each side of the equal sign.
Minus x?
Oh, minus 7.
Minus 7. Minus 7. 7 minus 7 is 0. And we have to keep it balanced. 9 minus 7 is 2, so x is 2. Okay. So moving on to number 2. By itself. How are we going to get x by itself?
Plus 3 over 4.
Good. Negative 3 fourths plus 3 fourths is 0, so now we have x plus 0. Great. And add 3 fourths. Yeah, we have to add 5 sixths and 3 fourths. How does that?
Common
denominator. 24?
12 over 2. I didn't find a common denominator, so like, I did everything except the common denominator.
That's important.
Yeah, I know.
If we forgot the common denominator, I'd say that's 3 out of 5.
Oh.
We're not finding common denominator. So 5, 6 plus 3, 4. So what did we decide the common denominator?
12.
12, okay. Multiply this by 2, multiply this by 2. We get 10 twelfths by 3 and by 3. 9 twelfths, so 19 twelfths, something like that. 19 twelfths, which is great, or 1 and 7 twelfths.
Yes.
Good job, bud. What? I can see. So, those two were similar to each other. What was similar about these two equations? In the way that we solved, adding or subtracting something to both sides. Either 19 twelfths or 1 and 7 twelfths. Now we have 5 times some number equals 15. So how will we get x by itself? This is different from those first two. Divide by 5?
And 5 divided by itself is 0.
No.
And 5 divided by 5?
Cancel itself.
1. 1.
But anyways, 5 goes into 15 3 times, and x equals 3. So pretty much, yeah.
So 1x is the same as x?
Yes, 1x is the same as x. So x is 3. 1x is 3, exactly the same, just as true. Okay. 5 divided by 5, 1, 3, x is 3. Any questions at all?
Nope.
Okay, if you didn't have your notes out already, you should now. More knowledge.
Do you have homework tonight?
Yes. There's no need for all the talking. Unless your notes are voice activated, and don't pretend like they are because you think you're funny. They're not. Okay. So now, we have something very similar to the last problem on this homework review that we just did. We have x divided by 4 is 2, so I don't want x divided by 4. What would I like to have? X divided by what?
5. No, 8.
No,
2. Yeah.
If I would just want to know what x is, then what would be the best thing to be dividing by? 1, yes, 1. Can we make that happen?
Yeah.
How?
By going 4 times 2, because instead of 5.
Nope, I don't want it. See, I understand what you're saying.
But
I don't want the, this is what you should have to do to 2. I want you to think, how do I get this to be a 1? Now you can use it as intuition, right? Some number divided by 4 is 2. So then 2 times 4 must be the number that we're looking for. Okay? We start there. Okay? Well, let's also think about this side of the equation and why it works out for this side of the equation as well. It makes sense, common sense, that's great. But like I said, we're making good habits. We're trying to establish good habits now so that complicated equations in the future don't require this huge leap over a giant cavern that we created because we have not practiced any good habits. Okay? So the reason why this side of the equation is simplified by multiplying by 4. Yeah, we have 4x over 4. And, well, if it's 4x over 4, that kind of looks like if I had 4x and I divided by 4, right? They get 1. 1x equals 2 times 4 is 8.
But instead of making it a 1, if we wanted to, couldn't we just, like, right from the beginning, just do the opposite of divide is multiply, so you do 4 times 4 to cancel. Then 4 times 2 equals 8, and then that would just be your answer.
You're saying pretty much what we did here, just in a different way. The opposite of dividing by 4 is multiplying by 4.
Yeah.
Yeah, simple. Okay. But you can just take, you know, 3/4 of a second, take a look and realize that the reason why that's working is because we're just getting 4 divided by 4. There's not really a better way to put it that maintains the math knowledge necessary. 4 divided by 4 is 1. Now really similar, we want to get 1 times x or x divided by 1. When we multiply this by 4, we wind up with this 4 divided by 4 situation. About negative x over 3 equals 7. Should have pens or pencils in hand. Writing this down. Good. Okay, we're so we just started to get a piece of paper out. So again, we want 1x or x over 1, whichever way you like to think about it. How can we make that happen when we have on this side negative x over 3? Multiply by what? Multiply by x? So you multiply by a positive x? Okay, if we multiply this by a positive x, say, depending on where you're, multiply by x on both sides. Alright, so I have x over 1. What's x times x?
X. Positive x.
No?
Negative x.
Okay. Well, okay, negative x times x.
Weird.
So you're saying that if I take x and multiply by x, I get x?
Oh.
Yes. That can't be, right?
I don't know how you're supposed to multiply letters. So.
Dalton?
I kind of did it how I did it the first time.
I'm asking what x times x is. What's x times x?
X squared.
X squared.
What?
Now, do we want x squared?
No. That's not what I was talking about.
Oh, you weren't talking about that. What are you talking about?
Like, well, wouldn't you do 3 over 1 times negative x over 3?
Okay. Sorry, I misunderstood. Multiply by 3 over 1. Multiply this by 3 over 1. This, we don't have to.
Bless you!
So we get negative. So negative x times 3 is negative 3x. Over 3 times 1 is 3, equals 21. What's negative 3 divided by 3?
4 is 1.
Negative 3 divided by 3?
0.
1. 3.
Let's just
negative 1.
Take a deep breath. Think about the answer before we just shout something out. Negative 3 divided by positive 3 is?
0.
4.
4
negative 1.
Negative 1. Negative one times x. That's really close. You're not very far away from knowing what x is. If a negative 1 times this x number, whatever this number is, gives you a positive 21, then what would have to be right there in that x?
Negative.
It'd have to be a negative.
Negative
1 times this number?
Negative
x. Negative 21.
A negative 21, that's what x would have to be. Negative 1 times negative 21 is positive 21.
Right? This is actually way easier for me.
It's not?
Still confused.
Okay, if we're confused, let's just concentrate on this one thing right now and stop talking. Okay. Negative 1 times x, just some number, right? Just like a blank. Negative 1 times blank equals 21. What would that number have to be so that negative 1 times this number is a positive 21? Negative 21, right? Negative 1 times negative 21 equals 21, right? That's what x was, a number that's being multiplied by negative 1. We get positive 21. So x must be negative 21. Okay? We're all thumbs up on that? Why x would have to be negative 21?
Yeah.
Okay. How about any of this? Any questions on any of this here?
Wait.
Nope.
Yeah, Avery.
How would it be a negative 21? Because a negative divided by a negative can't be a negative. It'd be a positive.
That's true.
So wouldn't that be just 21?
The answer is a positive.
The answer is x is negative 21.
And it would like the answer is actually positive. Like,
okay.
7 is positive.
So if we were to plug it back in the original was negative x over 3 equals 7.
Oh, I thought it was negative.
Negative 21 over 3 equals 7. So negative 21 over 3 is negative 7, and then times a negative is positive.
I thought the 7 was a negative.
Okay. Now, is there maybe a way that we could not have to do this step? Maybe from the beginning, could we have multiplied by something just slightly different?
Yep. 7.
Multiply by 7?
Or 3.
We did multiply by 3.
You could have just multiplied by 3 instead of doing the 1 over the 3 over 1.
So, this is the same. Multiply by 3 or 3 over 1. It's the same, yes?
I did negative 3 times 7 and just got negative 21.
Okay, I can see the trap you're gonna fall into because you're not listening to what I'm asking you to do. You're at a good starting place, but I want you to move away from saying, this is what I would have to do to find the number that I know that I'm supposed to have. And I want you to think about, how do I leave x by itself? Okay. So if we multiply 7 by negative 3, right, it's good common sense. But let's come over here, let's think about multiplying this by negative 3. That's gonna work out, okay? Because we have now negative x times negative 3. What's negative x times negative 3? Positive 3x. Okay. So we have to multiply by the same thing on this side, and so we get negative 21. Positive 3 divided by positive 3 is x. Or positive 3 divided by 3 is 1. 1 times x is. So if from the beginning we had taken care of the whole negative situation by multiplying by negative 3 instead of positive 3, and doing two things at once, we're making the x side positive, and we're canceling out that 3. Okay. So Dalton, when you say to yourself, this is what I would have to do to get the answer, right? I want you to do the same thing on the other side and like actually show all your work and show how. It's negative 3 times negative x is positive 3x, and the 3 divided by this 3 here gives me 1x. Okay? And I can promise in the future that skill's going to come in handy. Alright. So there's two situations where we have x divided by something. want to get x by itself, so we'll multiply by whatever x is being divided by. Next, let's look at 5/8 times x. It's 15. So over there on the board, we'd like to have 1 times x, not 5/8 times x. So what we do that will result in having a 1 times x?
Do we have to do 0.2 and 7?
Yes. That's there. What would we do so that we get 1 times x? What's that? What about 8 over 5? What would I do with it? Add it? I would add 8/5?
No.
Multiply
yeah.
by 8/5. Very nice. So this is 40 over 40, that's 1, that's 1x. 15 divided by 5 is 3, 3 times 8 is 24. Sit. I didn't ask you to leave. This is why we don't have very much time. A lot of this, worrying about everything but learning math. Okay? Chill. Here we would subtract 5 first. Divide by 3 next. X is 2/3. Have a good day.